Hello, today I'm here with a new video, and today I am here with a first impression, and this is a first impression of a palette and also a new brand for me. And the palette I'm going to try out is from Nomad, and it's the Tokyo Haruko, or is it only Tokyo? Yeah, Nomad Tokyo palette. And I have been wanting this for such a long time, and I think mostly Nicki Raven is the reason why I bought this. And the palette looks like this. It's really cute, but the thing I love the most is the prints in the pants. It's cats. I hope you can see, but it's cats on all except for the middle shade. That is Nomad's logo. But in all the others, it is cats. And I don't want to destroy the cats, but I guess I have to if I'm going to use it. And I like that it's different cats. So in the first row, it's the same cat, and it's a new cat in second, and the new cat in the third. So I'm going to use this today. And as I said, I have never used Nomad before, so it's going to be so fun. I know that a lot of people love this palette, and I think it's a really cute palette. So yeah, I am not going to swatch anything, as I never do, and I think I know what I want to do. We will see, but I think I know. Okay, so I think I will start with this purple one and this orange one in my crease, and this is Kawaii, and this is Takenokusoku, maybe. So I will take the purple out here and then the orange in the inner part. And I will start with the purple. And this palette I ordered such a long time ago. It took like 2.5 months or maybe 3 months before I got it. I ordered like right before US started to shut down the shipping outside of the US. So I think it was in the end of March I ordered it. Nomad had a sale, so I ordered it then, and I was like, yes, I got it. And then it was in Chicago for 8 or 9 weeks or something like that. But now I finally have it. And Nomad has been a brand that I've been very intrigued to use, because a lot of people seem to like their palettes. But it's like all fun indie brand from the US, it is so expensive with the shipping, and I also has to pay customs for everything. And now when it has been with COVID and everything, I didn't want to order, because it's like I don't know when I'm going to get it. Okay, I really like this purple. It is kind of like a pastel, but not the pastel, but it's like a dark pastel maybe. So I'm going in with the orange. And I hope that this is as good as the other one. And I don't know why I tap off my brush. I usually never do that. Okay, this I really like as well. And it seems like it's a helicopter outside. That I can take it on to the purple, and it doesn't, it still look good, like in the blend here. Really happy about that. And I'm trying to not poke the cat. And I'm taking this orange because I want the cat to stay. But what is this hair? Okay, I am really impressed with the blend,
between the orange and the purple. It looks really, really good. Almost as good as I want to use some other matte shades. But I actually think I want to go into the shimmers. And I am thinking about keeping it purple out here. So I will take this. I'm not going to try to pronounce this. But I don't know if this is like pressed glitter or something like that. Because if I remember correctly, I think it was Betty Jean maybe that did, I think it was her, that did a video about this and said that the top row was matte, the middle was like satins, and the bottom row was shimmers, I guess. I can't remember if it was Betty Jean, but I think it was. But I will go in with that dark, or the purple shimmer. It feels soft. And we'll see how it sticks to my eye. It looks really good. I don't know if this is somewhat of a topper, but at the same time it's lace on really good. And it's kind of opaque. It's really easy to apply. And it has like really nice shimmer to it. And I love that I can blend it a little bit up in my crease and it still doesn't like get glitter specks everywhere. I like that. I hate shimmers that you can't blend. I don't think you need to be able to put all the shimmers in your crease. But I like shimmers that are a little bit more smudge friendly. Do I even make sense? But like, you can work them into the crease and it's not only the glitter specks or the shimmer specks that is staying. It actually looks good. And I think these do. And it's easy to blend it together with the purple. And now I start to realize why people like Nomad. I was so close. I was so close to buying one more of the palettes. And after trying this, I don't think this will be the only palette that I'm going to have. I put my brush in the wrong shade. The only palette I have for Nomad, if I'm going to be honest. Okay, I really like this. Now I don't know if I want to go in with the green or with the yellow. Do you see my nails match? It was not on purpose. I think I actually will swatch these. Okay, the yellow goes... Okay, now I'll swatch on a really bad place on my arm. You can't see this. But the yellow has a like pink sheen to it, and the green is more of like a blue. And it's not that opaque, but I don't know if I even care, but then I don't know which one I want to go with. But I think I will go with the yellow one. This one, and put it in here, and we will see if it works like this. The brush pick it up good. We'll see how it sticks to the eye. Okay. Okay, so focus please. So on the brush it looks kinda yellow, but on the eye it'll look pink. I guess that these maybe are duochromes then. And this is one good reason for me that I should look up what kind of colors some shades are, like if it's a duochrome or what it is. Because if I have looked it up, I maybe wouldn't have taken that.
I like it, but it's not what I wanted it to be.
I wanted it to be green or yellow. It doesn't seem to be green in any kind of way I tilt my head. I'll go in a little bit more with the purple. Purple.
I like it,
this green, but it's not what I expected it to be. Okay, the only thing that bothers me now is here I only took the green shade and it looks kind of green, but here I took both the yellow and the green, so I think I have to put some of the yellow to look blue over this, just so the eyes look the same. And I'm going in with the orange. Tap it off. And just smudge it a little bit up here.
So okay, I like it. It is not what I did plan for, but I like it. So I will take away the fallouts, fix my base and my brows, and then we do the under eyes together. And I will also look up if it is duochromes, if it shimmers, what it is. Okay, so I checked what it was, the different shadows. So the first row is matte, the second row is shimmer, and the last one is multichromes, and that explains a lot. I still really like the look, actually, now. And it said with the multichromes that it worked best with either your finger or a wet brush or something really sticky, but I really think that it worked amazing just with my eyeshadow primer, especially this purple I have out here. So yeah, I really like it. And I think I wanted to do the boring thing with my lower lash. I think I'm just going in with these two that I have in my crease to make it a cohesive look. And then maybe go in with this one in my inner corner. We just have to wait and see. So I will take the purple like to here maybe, and then take the orange. And then I go in with the orange. Tap it off because I don't want any fallouts. Because I'm going to be so mad if something falls on my face. And I'm just like amazed how good these blend in together, the matte shadows. I am really, really impressed, but I'm not impressed. I'm going to pop something. Maybe I should take something in my own inner corner. I wonder how this looks. It seems to be blue and pink. I take it on my little pinky. This is going to be really blue, and just put it in here. Okay, it's just, it doesn't show up that much, but I still really like it. So I will put something in my wash line. I don't know if I want to take a pastel. I want to take something pastel, maybe a purple. I will see, and then I'll put on mascara, try to choose a lippy. I like to do these lighter looks now sometimes, but I never know what to put on my lips. So I will try to figure that out. So this is the finished look, and get her. I took a red lipstick. When in doubt, take a red. I was sitting here and like, it's flies that are doing sexual things. I
I've been sitting here a while, like, what am I going to use for lipstick? And then I was like, okay, fuck it, I take a red. So I took Rumors from Nabla, and on my waterline I took Cry Baby from ColourPop. Maybe should have gone with a darker red, but I still wanted to have it pretty light. So, my first impression of the Nomad Tokyo palette, I really like it. I love how good the orange and the purple blended together. It was so easy and just amazing. I'm so amazed. And also, this purple was so good and I really like it. And now, when I know that the bottom row is multichromes, I like the inner part of my lid as well. And they were really easy to work with, and I think with a glitter glue they would be amazing. But with only my eyeshadow base, my eye primer, I used the Milani one. I love this one. It was really good and such a nice palette to work with. I think it's so cute, and the shadows with little cats, I just love it. And it's going to be so fun to test out some of the shimmers as well. And I don't know if I'm maybe going to do a palette bingo with this, because I want to play with it more. And I'm really happy. My first impression is really good, and I would love to try something else from Nomad. I will see when I do it. They are coming out with a new palette in a couple of days, I think. I am not going to buy it at release date because I have bought too much eyeshadow palettes. I have 3, 5, 6. I have 11 palettes on the way. Happy that my boyfriend can't hear me now. But yeah, my first impression of the Nomad Tokyo palette is really good, and if the shades, or if the other palettes has the same formula, it is an amazing brand. And I don't know why I waited so long, because ever since I saw this palette the first time, I can't remember who it was. Maybe it was Annette or Beauty Bean. I don't know. I can't remember. Since that, I have wanted to try it, and now I finally have it, and I am so happy with it. It's so fun. So yeah, I really hope you like this video, and if you're not subscribing to my channel, please do, so you don't miss any of my videos, and I hope I will see you in the next one. Bye!